Hello, welcome to Arvind's Academy. That is a mathematical tool. And this is the lecture, second lecture on differentiation. So, watch this, and thereafter, this will be very interesting. So, here in last lecture, we had discussed about product rule, quotient rule, discuss about function of a function. Function of a function that is called chain rule. Chain rule, what is that? Try to understand. So we have differentiation of a function with respect to x, right now, and if sin x is there, then we can write it dy dx of, let me explain this, dy dx of sin x is cos x. It means this is applicable, this x is there and here is also x, then only it is applicable, otherwise it is not applicable. This formula is not applicable if there is anything else except x, or if there is anything except x. If both of them are x, then only it will be applicable, otherwise it is not applicable. Remember this, d by dx of sin x is cos x. If and only d by dx, this one is also x, then only it is applicable, otherwise it is not applicable. So if what will happen now, question is that what will happen if I have to differentiate d by dx of sine of log x, like this here, not x, but here instead of x there is log x. So what we'll do here, sine is a function of log and log is a function of x. So function of function, this is what. So we can write here d by d sine of log x. This formula is applicable, that whatever things is there, that should be here also. So we will write here d of log x, d of log x. So we need to multiply d of log x, and this dx was there, so we'll write here dx. Now sin x, in place of x there is log x. Sin derivative of sin x will be cos x, but in place of x there is log x. So we'll write cos of log x, and derivative of log x with respect to x is 1 by x. So that will be answer, right now. So you can use it like function of a function. One function is given and other function, like here, suppose I have to calculate sine of e to the power x, right? So here not, so again I can go ahead with this sine of e to the power x divided by, in place of x there is e to the power x. So I should write here d of e to the power x, and then again, so derivative of sine x is cos of e to the power x, isn't it? And this e to the power x is e to the power x, and that will be answer. So you can write it e to the power x cos e to the power x, that is e to the power x cos of e to the power x, that will be answer. So here function of function is there. We can write here some things like dy dx of sine 3x plus 5. So this sine 3x plus 5, so we can write here dy dx of sine 3x plus 5. In denominator, in place of x there is 3x plus 5. So in denominator also there should be 3x plus 5, multiply by, this is 3x plus 5, and then we can write here again plus 5 divided by dx. So what will happen, the sine derivative of sine is cos 3x plus 5 into, here derivative of 3x is 3 because it's 1, and derivative of 5 is 0, 3 plus 0, that is 3. So 3 times of cos of 3x plus 5. So one thing is clear, that you remember whenever you will write it directly, you can write it directly that derivative of sine x, sine ax plus b, remember sine ax plus b, a multiply by coefficient of x, that is a. Similarly, so this will be an important formula, you can use it. Similarly, d by dx of cos, say, 3x plus 7, right? Or 4x plus 5, say, like this. So, what right derivative of cos is minus sine 4x minus 7 multiply by coefficient of x, that is 4. So, we'll answer it minus 4 sine 4x minus 7 e to the power root x. Then, what we'll write here? D by dx of e to the power root x divided by d e to the power into d root x divided by dx. So, it will be e to the power x, derivative of e to the power x is e to the power x, and derivative of root x is 1 by 2 root x. So, answer is e to the power root x upon 2 root x. That will be the answer. So, this is what the chain rule. I hope you got it. Sometimes there is a question like d by dx of tan to the power 4x. What? So, this is nothing else but d by dx of tan x. So, it can be written like algebraic function d by d of tan x to the power 4. D by dx of tan x to the power 4. Tan power 4 divided by d of tan x. Right now? Multiply by d of tan x into dx. This is nothing else but it is like x to the power 4, dx to the power 4 upon dx. So that will be 4, power will be 1 reduced, that is 3, and derivative of tan x is sec square x. So answer will be 4 tan cube x sec square x. That will be the answer. So like that you can use it. I hope you got all this, how to deal with this right now. In direct way, we can write here d by dx of tan to the power 4. First, go for power. So, 4, power of 4 is 4 tan cube x directly, and then derivative of tan, that is sec square x. So, you can do it directly as well. There is no problem. So, direct method is this. Direct. So direct you can do like this. Now there is one more thing which I would like to discuss here, and that is parametric function. What is that? The function is defined in two different parameters, different. One function x is a function of sine t, and y is also described in terms of plus cos t, and you have to find dy by dx. This one, what? So here as t is parameter, because x is a function of t, here x is function of t, y is also function of t. T is called parameter. So the function is defined in form of t. So you have to find dy by dx. So we will calculate it like dx by dt and dy by dt, because x is a function of t. Since x is a function of t, so we'll differentiate them. Dx by dt is d by dt of sin x sin t, and sin t, derivative of sin t is cos t. So t plus cos t. So we can write dy by dt is equal to dy dt of t plus, derivative of t with respect to t is 1, and derivative of cos t with respect to t is sin t. Write a minus sin t. So now dy by dx can be written as dy by dx is nothing else but dy by dt whole divided by dx by dt, isn't it? Dy by dt whole divided by dx by dt. So we will write dy by dt is 1 minus sin t, and dx by dt is what? Dx by dt is cos t. So we will write here cos t. Write cos t. that will be answer. Even further, for more simplification, you can do anything, but it is not required. 1 minus sin t upon cos t. That is answer of this question. So implicit function, the parametric function is two different parameters. You have to calculate dy by dt, dx by dt, and then you have to divide it. T is parameter. It can be described in terms of theta as well. So one more question I would like to take on here. Say x is equal to theta sine theta and y is equal to 2 theta plus cos theta. Right now, find dy by dx, dy by dx. So again, in the similar fashion, we can write here, in similar fashion, we can write here that dx by d theta solution. Right now, let me write here, solution is dx by d theta. Dx by d theta. So here theta into sine theta, these are the product of two things, so you will apply product rule, d by d theta of theta sine theta. So here product would be applied, theta as it is, derivative of sine theta plus sine theta as it is, derivative of d by d theta of theta. So what will come in that case? This will be theta is cos theta and plus sine theta, right now derivative of d theta by d theta is 1. Similarly, dy by d theta, theta of 2 theta plus cos theta. So we will write here derivative of 2 theta, that is 2, and cos theta, derivative of cos theta is minus sine theta. So 2 minus sine theta, right now. And now dy by dx is equal to, we can write here, therefore divided by dx by d theta. So that will come here up like dy by d theta is 2 minus sine theta and dx by d theta is theta cos theta plus sine theta. So you will write answer like this. That will be the answer. There is no problem, and I hope you got this. You understood this well, how to deal with parametric function. And one more thing is that implicit function, that I would like to discuss here. Implicit function, what is that? So starting with the new page, implicit function. Implicit, what is that? Implicit function. Function is included in xy is equal to c is called implicit function. That is a function in which neither x can be expressed in terms of y, x can be expressed in terms of y, in terms of y, nor y can be expressed in terms of x, in terms of x exclusively. Such functions are called implicit function. Implicit function. Right now, such functions are called implicit functions. Now, you have some questions like x square plus xy plus y square is equal to 0. This is an implicit function. Find dy by dx. How to deal with this question? Here neither x can be expressed exclusively in terms of y, nor y can be expressed exclusively in terms of x. then that is why this is called an implicit function. So how to find dy by dx? Find dy by dx. So to solve, this is a question and solution is here. Differentiating with respect to x, that is d square plus dy dx of xy plus dy dx of y square is equal to dy dx of 0, that is 0. So here derivative of x square will be nothing else but 2x, and here product rule is applicable, so we will write x as it is derivative of dy dx of y, as it is derivative of x. Here chain rule is applicable, dy square upon dy into dy upon dx, because this y square will be differentiated if and only if there is y here. So we can write now, this will be 2x plus x dy by dx plus y by dx is 1. Now here this derivative is 2y, and that is dy by dx is equal to 0. So put the value of dy by dx, the terms which is involved dx, dy by dx, that is together. Here x plus 2y dy by dx is equal to 0, and therefore x plus 2y dy of 2x plus y, and now dx is equal to minus of 2x plus y whole divided by x plus 2y, and that will be answer of this. So implicit function is something, a function where x and y are not together, they are mixed, and one cannot be expressed in terms of another. For example, if it is given that y is equal to sine of x plus y, find dy by dx, like this. Here again x and y cannot be separated easily, so we can find it. Solutions like, again we will write differentiation. Solutions is differentiating with respect to x. We have, what is that? D by dx of y, this side, d by dx of sine x plus y, right? So using the same thing here also, we can write dy by dx is equal to, right now, what is that? Dy dx sine of x plus y. Then in denominator, because angle is x plus y, so in denominator there must be x plus y. And here d of x plus y and divided by dx, this one dx, right now. So now this can be further written as, this further can be written as dy by dx is equal to cos of x plus y, derivative of sine is cos, and this one is 1 plus, because dx by dx is 1 and dy by dx is remain dy by dx. So put the terms together, dy by dx one side, so it will be 1 minus cos of x plus y dy by dx, and here the cos x plus y multiply by 1 only, so it will be cos of x plus y, cos of x plus y. And now dy by dx can be written as, here I can write dy by dx is equal to, what is that? Cos x plus y whole divided by, let me write on the next page, there is no problem. Okay, so therefore dy by dx, this will multiply that side and it will be divided. So dy by dx is equal to, therefore dy by dx is equal to cos of x plus y whole divided by 1 minus cos of x plus y, and that will be the answer. So in this way, you can do some questions. There can be questions like differentiate under root 4x cube minus 5 with respect to x. Right now, how to deal with this question? So here we have to find derivative of this one d by dx with respect to x under root of 4x cube minus 5. Under root is nothing else but power. So there, this power is root, and we know the derivative of root is 1 by 2 root x. So you can write it directly. 1 by 2 root x in place of x, that will be there. So you can use it directly, like, but derivative of root x is 1 by 2 root x. So I can write here, the derivative of this root is 1 by 2 root, and in place of x, this is 4x cube minus 5. And then derivative of 4x cube minus 5. Earlier I did here, the derivative of root is 1 by 2 root x, and then again this one. Now derivative of x cube is 3x square. 3x square multiplied by 4 is 12x square, and derivative of 5 is 0. So that will be 12x square divided by 2 times of 4x cube minus 5. So 2 cancel this 6 times. So answer is 6x square upon under root 4x cube minus 5. That will be the answer. So like that, you can do these questions. Another questions can be there also. X square plus b, find dy by dx. If I'll write dy by dx, it means in place of y there is cos of x square plus b. Here angle is x square plus b, so in denominator upon b of x square plus b, right now x square plus b multiply by d of x square plus b whole divided by dx. So that will come up here, like derivative of cos h plus b multiply by d x square plus b divided by dx. Now derivative of cos h sine. So answer will be minus sine ax square plus b into derivative of x square is 2ax, and derivative of b is 0. So the answer is, this will be the answer, right? Now you can write 2x earlier. Some questions are like this. We can have some questions also, some other type of questions, like e to the power tan theta. If e to the power tan theta is y, find dy by d theta, right? Dy by d theta. So again, if I'll write here dy by d theta, then what will happen? D e to the power tan theta divided by d theta. But we know, since we know d by dx of e to the power x is e to the power x, for that region there must be x here and x there as well. So because here e to the power is tan theta, so you need to write tan theta. D e to the power tan theta whole divided by d tan theta into d tan theta whole divided by d theta. So the things will come like e to the power x is e to the power x. So answer will be e to the power tan theta, and derivative of tan theta is sec square theta. So answer is sec square theta e to the power tan theta. That will be the answer. So I hope many questions are discussed here, and you are familiar with all these questions. You can do it. Now if x is equal to a t and b is equal to y is equal to bt square, find dy by dx. Y is equal to bt square. So we can solve it like dx by dt. because t is parameter here. So a is constant, you know, that will be taken outside, and tq, derivative of tq is with respect to t is 3t square. So that will be 3at square. Dy by dt is what? B is constant and derivative of t square is 2t. So that is 2bt. And now dy by dx is equal to, therefore, dy by dx is equal to, dy by dx is equal to dy by dt divided by dx by dt. So dy by dt is what? 2bt, and dx by dt is 3at square. So this t and t cancel, that is 2b upon 3at, and that will be answer of this question. So hopefully you understood all these things, how to deal with these questions. Some more questions we can discuss, and let's see if it is written like this. If question is displacement of a particle is given by x is equal to 5t square minus 7t plus 8, right? Find velocity of the moving particle when t is equal to 5 seconds, right? Second. So in this question, the displacement x is given. X is displacement, and you know velocity is nothing else. Velocity is dx by dt. Rate of change of displacement is called velocity. So we will write dx by dt, dy dt of x. X is 5t square minus 7t plus 8. So that will be d by dt of 5t square minus dy dt of 7t plus dy dt of 8. Isn't it? So you know all these things, and you will have here v is equal to 5t square. Derivative of 5t square is 10t, because t square is 2t, and 5 into 2t, that is 10t. 7 will come outside of this, and derivative of t is 1, so that is 7, and derivative of it is 0, right now? So when t is equal to 5 seconds, right, then v is equal to 10 into 5 minus 7, 50 minus 7, that is 43 meter per second. Velocity is given in meter per second. Displacement is described in meter, right now? So in this one, when displacement is in meter, displacement is in meter, right now? Meter m. So like this. Similarly, a particle is moving in a straight line. There is another question I am taking here. If a particle is moving along a straight line, along a straight line, and its motion, equation of motion at any instant of time, is given by v is equal to 3t square plus 5t minus 2. Find acceleration. Find its acceleration when t is equal to 2 seconds. Right now. So again you will write the same thing. You know acceleration is solution. Acceleration is a is nothing else but dv by dt. Right now. So velocity is given here, that is dv by dt, and equation of motion along a straight line is given. So dy dt of 3t square plus 5t minus 2. So here, therefore, a is equal to derivative of 3t square, that is dy dt of 3t square plus dy dt of 5t minus dy dt of 2, right? So that will be here 3 times of dy dt of t square, isn't it? And 5 will come outside, and that will be t, and the derivative of this is 0. So that is 3 into 2t plus 5 into 1, that is 6t plus 5. And when t is equal to 2 second, acceleration will be when t is equal to 2 second, acceleration a will be 6 into 2 plus 5, that is 17 meter per second square. So acceleration is 17 meter per second square. You understood all these things and nicely, and definitely you have enjoyed it. More questions to be practiced to get some confidence, and this is the basic of differentiation. Basic differentiation that is required for solving questions in physics. So we will use it, and you know the derivative of velocity, well, rate of change of velocity is an expression, rate of change of displacement. So all these things is applied here, and that will be used in future also. So till then, God bless, keep watching, and don't forget to subscribe this channel, right? God bless.